First at 10, a hit and run caught on camera. The vehicle at the center of this crash stolen from an 80-year-old woman.
What did I ever do to anybody? Nothing.
The emotional significance behind this car now heavily damaged.
And a big development tonight in the arrest of a student accused of recording a teacher under her skirt. The shocking way the teacher found out.
Rain and storm chances go up this week, and with the risk for severe storms, I've got that timing. The news starts right now.
And we begin with this breaking news. We are just learning tonight that a person is in custody in connection to the church fires in St. Landry Parish.
KATC is reporting that the suspect is the son of a St. Landry Parish deputy. The FBI, ATF all joined in on the investigation into the suspicious fires at three historically black churches in St. Landry Parish. The first happening at St. Mary Baptist Church in Port Barre. That was on March 26th. The second at Greater Union Baptist Church in Opelousas just days later on April 2nd. And 2 days after that, another fire broke out in Opelousas at Mount Pleasant Baptist Church. Tomorrow, a press conference will be held with the governor, the FBI, and ATF. We will bring you the very latest details as soon as they become available.
And also tonight, the search is on for the driver and passenger caught on camera slamming into a vehicle in a stolen car. Tonight only on 6, the 80-year-old owner of that stolen car is speaking out.
And she has a message for the young men responsible. WDSU's Juliana Mazza live tonight with her chilling account of a story you'll hear right here on 6. Juliana.
At Sean Sella, it takes some pretty terrible people to rob an 80-year-old woman. That woman's name is Ruth, and this wasn't a carjacking. See, Ruth's purse was stolen while she was grocery shopping, and it was 9 hours later that the suspects return and track something down from Ruth that was priceless.
They don't know what I've gone through.
It's hard to imagine what kind of person would rob Ruth McCannisby.
I'm 80 years old. What did I ever do to anybody? To you? Nothing.
Ruth was shopping at a West Bank Walmart Sunday when her life took a horrible turn.
And this young man was running real fast. I heard him first. And he hit my basket with a lot of force. And it scared me.
NOPD says that man stole her purse. In it, credit cards, a Medicare card, her military benefits ID, and her license.
The license had that address on it, and that's where I parked it, right next door.
Hours after the theft, Ruth says the suspect used the license to find her address and steal her car that, for her, was truly priceless.
Well, I was devastated. I only have the one car. It was given to me by my daughter who passed away. She was real young. She died of colon cancer.
This car probably meant a little something
it
to you.
It meant everything to me.
And what happens next left Ruth speechless. These young men not only tracked down and stole her car, but crashed it into someone else's car and ran off.
I don't fault those young people. I fault the parents because they can do better. You can do better. You can love those children enough to want them not to ever do anything like that. I feel sorry for somebody that thinks they have to steal something from somebody else.
If you recognize the young men in this video, you can help Ruth get some justice. You can call the NOPD or call Crime Stoppers anonymously. That number 504-822-1111. Live outside of NOPD headquarters tonight, Juliana Mazza, WDSU News.
All right, Juliana, thank you. Tonight, a legal expert is weighing in on a startling arrest in Slidell. This student taken into custody for allegedly recording his teacher in a very inappropriate area. WDSU's Tammy Eswick has been following this story since it first broke earlier today. And Tammy, you have some new details on where the student is right now.